Hello and welcome. Today I show you how you can use Windows 10 as a pro, as a professional. Okay, first thing I will do is show you the on-screen keyboard so you see exactly what I'm doing. This is mostly about keyboard shortcuts, the most popular keyboard shortcuts. So to show you the on-screen keyboard, I will just type search, press the start menu and search for on-screen keyboard. You don't really have to use this. This is mostly just to help you see what I'm doing better. So the next thing I'm doing is just to create a new text document. Let's call it test. That's creative. Okay, so now you see if I press each key, it works. Okay, so if I press on my keyboard, you don't see the actual letters, but when I press Alt or Control or Windows key, you see the Windows key, it shows there. Control, Shift, Function, I'm not gonna use it. Caps, Tab. Tab doesn't show it. And Escape. Okay, so the first thing, I will just type some testing text. I will just copy this a few times. And if you see what I'm doing, I just make a lot of text really fast. So the most important, the most important keyboard shortcuts you will ever use on any Windows computer, the way I was able to do this all so fast was, probably you know this already, but I'm just saying it, some of these shortcuts you might not know, so keep watching, you might learn something new, even if this one is very simple for you. If it's not, if you don't know this, then this is really important to know. The first thing to do, the most important commands are how to copy text, how to cut text, to remove it, to move it somewhere else, and how to paste text. And these are very simple. How I'm doing this, I select the text I want to copy. For example, this one, text testing. And I press on the keyboard, Control, and at the same time I press C, the key C. And then I let go of Control and C. Again, I'm sorry if this is really basic for you, but some people might not know this and it's useful to learn something new. And this is very important to know this. Then I go to some empty space on the text file, and this works in any document, any program. All the programs support this, even a browser or the search bar. For example, I could search for this by just pressing Control V. Yeah, there's someone has a GitHub about text test. Okay, so how I paste this, if you see this again and again and again, I press Control, and while pressing Control, I press V. You see, yeah, now I'm doing it on the screen so you see better. So I press on the keyboard, I don't need to press with the mouse, I'm just showing you here so you see this. So on the keyboard I press Control and then at the same time V. V again, V, and it doesn't show on the screen, but that, this is what I'm doing. So now on the screen to see better. Yeah. Okay, so I have this text here and I decide to move the text from here to the end. Instead of Control C, how we did it at the beginning, I use Control X to cut it. So I keep pressing Control and then X. You see it's gone from there. And I go in the place where I want it to be pasted. So it's cut and paste we do now. And to paste it, it's Control and V. So on the keyboard, and if I do it multiple times, it will paste the value again and again, just like before. Okay, so Control C, it's copy. Control V, it's paste. Control X, it's cut. I'll do it again. Control X, it's cut. And again, Control V to paste. If you know this, you can do most of the tasks a lot easier, much easier. You also have the option to do this from the menus, so you can do it from here, edit, you see. And another trick here is whenever you see cut, copy, paste, even delete, try to stay away from delete. Yeah, unless you really want to get rid of something. So whenever you go in a menu, in a file or edit menu, you will see the command name and the shortcut for it. Control X, Control C, Control V, the delete key on the keyboard, find is Control F. So when you're in a document, I will put something here. So I'm in this document and I'm trying to find something. I could either use from here find and then type what I want to search for, and it will highlight it for me. This works in any program. This window might be a little different, but it's always kind of the same thing after all. And you can search direction up or down. So if I'm here and I search up, it will go up. If I try to find it again, it won't find it. So if I'm here, I'm in this place and I go up, can't find it because it's below. So best thing is to go at the beginning of the document, search down, find next. Make sure the case is unchecked so that you can search in more, or if you want to search for capital, haha, then you will match case. This thing, I can do it the same thing with the keyboard, Control F, and I search for haha, and there it is. Okay, other than this, these are the most useful commands, and I will make a new document now just to show you the next one. So I have this document, and did you see what happened there? I moved between them, between the keyboard and the document. So there is the Alt, instead of clicking here and then switching to the other one, and clicking here and switching to the other one. If you go between two programs really fast, you can use the Alt Tab command. So if you press Alt Tab and then you release it, or you can keep pressing Alt and press again Tab a few times. You see, every time it presses Tab, it highlights a new window, so you can choose another one, or you can click it. So you can click the window you like to use. So Alt Tab and release it, Alt Tab and release it, like this, it will switch a few times. Like, you can do this as many times as you like. If you press two times Tab, it will switch to another window. So now it's just switching between on the screen keyboard and the test file. If you want to lock the computer, you press the Windows key and L to lock it. And it's locked. It's useful if your computer is not in a private space and you want to make sure that nobody will use the computer while you're away from the screen. Another key that is related to the Windows key is the Windows key plus D. That means also the Windows key is the start menu. So you already know probably. You press Windows key and that is the start menu to search for some programs. Windows key plus Windows key, you keep pressing it and then you press D, it will show the desktop like this. All the windows disappear and you have the desktop. You press it again, you see all the windows back. This is useful if you want to just quickly get a file on the desktop and you don't want to play with the windows, you rearrange them. If I have a big block of text and I want to edit this one specifically here, but my cursor is on the left here and I try to avoid using the mouse as much as possible. For example, let's say this one is misspelled for whatever reason. So I'm here, you see my cursor is there on the second line. Here, this is where the mouse is, here. And the actual editing cursor is here where I move it left and right with my keys. Let me show you the keyboard also. So I can move the left key, right key, up key, down. Use this to navigate the edit point. So this is where I will edit some text if I wanted to. So if I want to go there, it's taking a bit of time. Imagine if this is a long document and you don't want to go through each one, like keep pressing the left or right. You can press Control right and it will jump to the next word. Control right, you see, jumps to the next word. And then again, I can press. And then again, I can press Control right and it goes to the next word. And I can press left a few times, Shift select. So I press the shift key and the left arrow two times to select this word that's misspelled, and then delete to remove it. It's better actually not to use a delete key. Instead of doing that, it's better to use backspace, because backspace, it's a bit safer. So you might, if you use the delete key, maybe you had something else selected and it will delete that, but backspace doesn't do that. So I go here to the edit point, I press shift, and then I press on the left key two times to remove this and press backspace and it's gone. So control right arrow, you see how it jumps from word to word, right arrow, and you can navigate the whole line much easier like this. But let's say if you want to jump from here to the end of the line, you don't want to go control and right, it's there's a key for that. There's the end key on your keyboard. Press end and you're here, you see, you're at the end of the line. Then there is this space here. If I want to delete that space, I press shift, keep pressing, and then left, delete, and it's gone. I will put two new lines now, two spaces. Hopefully this is not too boring for you. I really hope you're not falling asleep now, or you didn't just close the video. But it's really useful to know how to do this, because a lot of people don't know how to do this and they don't know that it's so easy to do it. In this way, you don't touch the mouse. If you notice, I'm not touching the mouse and you can be much more productive in this way. And you see, I deleted it. Okay. Another thing which is really important, and I really forgot to tell you, which is one of the most important things, and I did it a few times without even telling you, is control S is to save the document. So control and S on the keyboard will save the document. Again, you don't have to do it on the on-screen keyboard, on your normal computer keyboard, control S. Just if you see, when I type this S, there is a small star next to the file. Usually the programs, they will do this, they will show you a star when the file is not saved yet. And when I press Control S, the star is gone, means the file is saved. This is super important. Type a whole line, Control S. It will save automatically. Most of the programs will do that. For example, Notepad, I think it doesn't really do that. But if you use Word, it will do that automatically, but just to be sure, Control S, make it a habit. So about the lines, so I'm going to the end of the line, and if I want to go to the beginning of the line from here without going with Control and like this word by word, I'm at the end of the line here and I want to go to home. I will press home on the keyboard and there I am at the home, the beginning of the line. So end, home, end, home. You see how it jumps from one to the other. Now, if I wanted to select a word here, I press shift and then left arrow, left one by one, and select the text I want. So there is a better way to do that. If you want to select specific words, you go with control left to the words you want to select and then press control shift and then left arrow, and you see it jumps the same way as you press control and left arrow, but it also selects because of the shift. And this is really useful. Delete or backspace and it's gone. Control Z is to undo. So you see I deleted the text here, and to undo that change, you can see this from the menu, from edit, I have Control Z. Yeah. But here they don't show it in this menu. There is also an undo for the undo. So okay, let's do that. So I will press Control and Z to undo. That's on the keyboard. And then if you want to redo the action you did before, so kind of undo the undo action, you press Control Shift Z. So Control Shift Z is the reverse of Control Z. So it will redo the last action. So you can do it a few times. Control Z, Control Shift Z. Like this. So these are really useful to undo. And again, I have the file unsaved. I want to save it at this point to make sure I have the file. If I make a change and it asks me to save it, it's up to you, but I would say always choose save. This way the text is still there. If I make this change here, I put few letters here, but I don't change the file. I don't save the file when I close it. I will have the file to the previous state that was saved without those and the last edit. So I showed you this one with the control shift and left arrow. You go and select the text. You can also go to the beginning home. I wish this keyboard, on-screen keyboard, would show you all the screen. So I press home, end, and then if I press shift and end, it selects the whole line. And if I press end again, it will deselect the line. So I press shift home, it selects the whole line, and then home again to deselect the line. So let's do it again. Shift, end, and I press end again, it deselects the line, and I press shift, home, selects the line, and here if I want to get rid of it, I just press backspace or delete and it's gone. And then another delete to remove the next line. Okay, so let's say I'm in the middle of the document somewhere and I say from this point down, I want no more of this text. I want to delete it all. So how to do it? I press shift and then just down arrow. And you see how it selects the text one by one until the end. And I could select only two rows and delete those with the shift, with the backspace or delete. But if this document is really big and I want to delete everything from this point onward and so I press shift and it's one line, and if I press shift control shift and it selects the whole document from that point, and then I can delete it if I want. So from this point here, if I want to go to the beginning and select all the text from here to the beginning, I press shift, it's control shift home. And if I want to go from here to the end, it's control shift end, and I can delete the whole text. Yeah, these are super useful. There's control shift home, control shift end, or shift home, shift end. The control basically says to the whole document. So the whole document, or the end or the beginning, home and end. I think these are pretty much the most useful text editing keyboard shortcuts that you, if you know this, at the beginning it might be difficult, but once you get used to them, it's really much easier to edit text. You can use shift or control like how it should be. Whenever you don't know for sure how you should do this, you always look in the edit and the file menu format. You will see in the edit, you will see the keyboard shortcuts to get things done much easier for you. I hope this video is not too boring. I hope you're still watching. Okay, let me know in the comment section below how you find this video. If it's too hard to watch, let me know. Try these keyboard shortcuts yourself if you didn't use them already, if you didn't know them already. Try to get used to using the shift, control shift a lot, and the alt. You can also do it with the mouse, this thing. But with the keyboard, you have a lot more control on precisely where to go. One last thing is, if you want to delete everything, you press control A, select all, and delete. Thanks for watching. Bye.